सो मार्जिन इज द जंक्शन ऑफ द नॉर्मल एपिथीलियम विद द एबनॉर्मल एपिथीलियम. दिस इज द मार्जिन एंड द फ्लोर इज व्हाट वी सी. Hi everyone, my name is Dr. Shardul Vikram Gupta. About my background, I have done MS General Surgery from UCMS and MCH Minimal Access Surgery from AIIMS New Delhi. So now coming to the ulcer definition first, what is ulcer? This is the epidermis, this is the dermis, and this is the subcutaneous tissue. The ulcer is defined as break in the continuity of the covering epithelium, skin or mucous membrane, which has occurred either due to molecular death of the surface epithelium or by traumatic removal. Either the trauma removes the outer surface or due to some pathology, the outer layer dies and there is an ulcer formation. So when this layer goes, then it becomes ulcer. So now coming to some theory behind this, before jumping to the examination, what are the part of the ulcer? As you can see, this is the base of the ulcer. This is the floor of the ulcer and this is the edge and this one is the margin. So you must differentiate what is difference between edge and the margin and what is difference between floor and the base. So margin is the junction of the normal epithelium with the abnormal epithelium. This is the margin and the floor is what we see. Imagine the floor where you are sitting just right now. You can see the tiles over there. That is the floor, the visible part, but you cannot see the basement behind it. So you can see the floor, but you cannot see the base. For base, you must feel it. Like here, you can see the floor here, but you are not able to see the base, which is actually the bone, the medial malleolar part of the tibia. So the base is not visible. What you see is the floor of the ulcer. So in written words, the margin is junction between the normal epithelium and the ulcer, which is also known as boundary of the ulcer. And the edge is area between margin and the floor of the ulcer. And the floor is only the exposed surface between the ulcer and base is on which the ulcer rests. And it is better felt than seen. So now coming to history taking in case of an ulcer. Firstly, you have to ask about mood of onset. How has the ulcer developed? Whether it was a trauma or it developed spontaneously or it developed after a minor trauma. Usually in diabetes, or in a patient with peripheral arterial disease, the ulcer starts with a minor trauma, but it can start spontaneously in several conditions. Margolis ulcer is an ulcer actually which develops in a scar mark. Say a person has got burned and after 20 years in a burn scar due to chronic inflammation, the squamous cell carcinoma develops. That particular ulcer is known as margolis ulcer. So you must ask the duration of the ulcer also, for how long the ulcer has been and whether it is painless or painful. In conditions where there is a neurological deficit like trophic ulcer or the syphilitic ulcer or any neurological condition like Tapes dorsalis, there will be no pain because the ulcer itself develops due to loss of sensation and due to repeated trauma, the patient is not able to feel whether the foot is getting traumatized or not. Due to repeated trauma, the ulcer develops. So that will be a painless ulcer. When there is a pain, then it means it is either inflammatory ulcer or it is due to trauma. So you must ask about the discharge, the nature of discharge, the type of discharge, the amount of discharge, the nature will be is whether it is serous, serosanguinous or pus or purulent. And you must inquire the associated disease like neurological problem. As I already mentioned, Tapes dorsalis, diabetes, and other problems like peripheral arterial disease or varicose. Can any one of you tell me what is the importance of position of ulcer?
In the dependent parts and bedridden patients.
The venous ulcer are usually in lower limb in the gaiters area. I'll tell you shortly what I mean by gaiters area. And after ascertaining the position of the ulcer, you will see how the margins are. I have told you the definition of the margin. Margin is between normal and abnormal. This is the margin and this is the edge. This is the margin and this is the edge. Peculiarity of rodent ulcer is that it is usually confined to the upper part of the face, above the line joining the angle of the mouth and to the lobule of the ear. If you draw a line from angle of the mouth to the lobule of the ear, the rodent ulcer usually lies above it and it is called rodent because it usually gives the appearance as if rodent have bitten on the face. And the tubercular ulcer, the position will be usually at the site of the lymph node, like cervical lymph node or inguinal lymph node. And trophic ulcer are common on the heel of the foot or ball of the foot. Like you see here, this is the trophic ulcer where there is a repeated pressure area. And Shankar, you already know, it will be on genitalia. So now coming to gaiters area, the venous ulcer are usually located at the gaiters area. The lower part of the leg is known as gaiters area. And usually the venous testis ulcer is found in the gaiters area, most commonly at the medial malleolar. Reason can occur anywhere in this area, which is known as gaiters area. So this is an important MCQ question, and this is usually asked in professional exam also. So what is gaiters area? The name derives from this protective clothing. This is the gaiter, the literal meaning of the gaiter. This protective clothing is worn by the snow workers to protect snow from entering the boot here. So now coming to edge of the ulcer. So the types of edges are undermined edges, which is usually seen in tuberculosis. Do you know why it becomes undermined? Because the disease process destroys the subcutaneous tissue faster than it destroys the skin. Therefore, the subcutaneous tissue destruction is much more than the skin destruction here, and the edges become undermined. So the second type of edge is punched out, as if you have punched something, which is seen in trophic ulcer. And the edge drop down at right angle to the skin surface as it has been cut out with a punch, which is seen in the trophic ulcer. This is the punched out edge, directly at the right angle to the skin surface. As you see here, this is the punched out ulcer. Now coming to next edge, which is the sloping edge, it is usually seen in healing ulcer. Can you see here, the edges are sloping? You can not make a sharp demarcation here. The edge is sloping here. Yes. The next one is raised and pearly white beaded edge, which is seen in rodent ulcer. So the edge will be pearly white and raised, but it will not be everted like this. Everted edge is something different. This is the raised edge, which is seen in rodent ulcer, which is also known as basal cell carcinoma. And about everted edge, it is seen in squamous cell carcinoma. What happens is the growing portion of the edge of ulcer heaps up and it spills over the normal tissue. So the in raised ulcer, the edge will be only till here. It will not be heaping or spilling onto the normal. So once you have determined the margin and the edge, then you will inspect for any discharge, the character of discharge, the amount of the discharge, the smell, whether it is foul smelling or not, the serosanguinous discharge, which is usually seen in tubercular ulcer, and ulcer infected with B. pyocyania or pseudomonas will be greenish in color. And you must inspect the surrounding area, how the surrounding area is, whether there redness or whether there is lipodermatous sclerosis, whether there is pigmentation or not. And you must inspect the whole limb for varicosity or presence of peripheral arterial disease. So now coming to palpation, first in palpation, you will confirm all the inspectory findings. When you will present the case, you will say to the examiner, sir, you will say, sir, I have confirmed my all inspectory finding on my palpation, and then you will start further. Then you will say that whether the ulcer is tender or not. Then you will actually feel for edge and margin, whether there is marked induration or not. The marked induration of edge is characteristic of the carcinoma, but the marked induration of the base is characteristic of the syphilitic chancre. So you must assess the depth of the ulcer, whether it is deep ulcer or the shallow ulcer, whether any bleeding associated with it or not, and relation to the deeper structures, whether the deeper structure is by muscle or by bone, or how the surrounding skin. So if you pick the ulcer, then you will see, you will be able to feel for the base. So if you pick the ulcer here, you will feel that the base is formed by either by bone or by the muscle. But in medial malleolar region, it is usually the bone. And the floor is what you see. So after doing that, you will do examination of the lymph node, and then examination for vascular insufficiency, and then neurological examination, which is a separate class. So I have developed a clinical surgery app in Android Play Store, which you can download, and you can go in this menu section and you'll find information about all the important cases here. So when you go into the ulcer, you'll find all the history part, all the examination part here in this tab, and then history part in this tab. So that's all. Thank you guys.